my solo. I want make me go solo.
Drumsticks.
I ain't call you up, open me, try a holy air. I ain't call you up, open me, try a holy air. Oh, she's at you, cooking bad, try a holy air. Only London, all up Paris, brother, try a holy air. Oh, my way, oh, back badger, oh, I am okay.
First thing. This is optional, but I'm gonna customize my frontal. You can do it before, you can do it after, but I prefer to do it before. And I'll leave all the products that I'm using in the info section down below. When you're buying a lace frontal, there are some companies that have the option of a dark lace, a medium lace, and a light lace or transparent lace. And the lace frontal I'm using is a dark lace. And unfortunately, I cannot give you the details at the moment because I'm trying it out. I'll leave some companies in the info section down below that you guys can check out for frontals.
To the realest, to the biggest. To my niggas with the frosh, to the poor and the rich, reality me the preach. Call up all the late, oh, take me jolly jolly.
It's time to start thinning out the front of the frontal to make it appear more realistic. I'm using a tweezer and I'd say you need to invest in a good tweezer, because I tried it before with like an old tweezer that I used to have, and pretty much when I got a new tweezer I saw a big difference. And when I was getting this new tweezer, yeah, no story time, sorry, it was quite expensive, and I was like, why the hell is this so expensive? But it was actually way better because it makes everything go by faster. So if you can invest in a good tweezer, I think it was about maybe $5 or more, I don't remember, but yeah, I remembered it was a little bit more expensive than like $1 or $2 tweezer that you typically would get. And I got it from Sally, I believe. There's not really like a good way for me to really explain this, but I pretty much twisted it till it started to look kind of normal to me, because you know, my own natural hairline is not like super full, and when I put this on I started to look like a Barbie doll. So I need to tweeze it some to get some hair out in the front and, you know, make it look a little natural. So I just kind of follow the shape of a typical kind of hairline, like kind of like mine. That's what I like to use as a guidance. And sometimes frontals have some dips and curves that can guide you as well, so you know where to go in more at or where not to go in too much at. And this can take some time. You can decide to pull it out with your hand instead, but I prefer to use a tweezer because I can control things better. Once I kind of got like a shape that I like, I start to create this little edge hair at the front, like a little fuzzy piece at the front, which is gonna make sense at the end because it kind of makes it look a bit more realistic as well. It helps to cover the line of demarcation of the lace when you place it on your head, and it also, you know, just makes it look a bit realistic, more realistic. I'm gonna say realistic a lot in this video, heads up. Once done, you might start to see this ashy looking dots on the lace, or just the lace might be lighter than your skin tone. Pretty much start to see these things that look like chicken skin when you pluck out the feathers. Especially when you're dark skin, it doesn't look too attractive when you put it on. So what I'm gonna do now is tint the lace, and I'm using a semi-permanent hair color by Adore. And these things come in different colors, so if you're lighter than me or if you're darker than me, I'm mixing like about a tablespoon or two with hot water, and then I'm pretty much soaking the frontal in it for about 5 minutes, and then I rinse it off. The amount that you use when you're doing the mixture can determine how dark you can go or how light you can go, or like you just kind of like play with it. And since this is a semi-permanent color, if you shampoo it like a couple of times, it's gonna start to fade and get lighter. So like say you got the frontal too dark, then you can shampoo it, it's gonna get it a little lighter. But if you get it not dark enough, then you can repeat the process of, you know, tinting the lace one more time. And don't be alarmed, it might look a bit orangey slash yellow at first, but once it dries into something more normal looking like this. And this is me trying it on, and it looks pretty good to me. This thing got me thanking God for life. So now we're gonna start making the wig, and I'm gonna leave all the instruments or whatever I use in the info section down below. There are two wig caps I like to use, a dome cap and an adjustable wig cap. And a dome cap is pretty much like a universal size, can fit heads from about maybe 21 inches to about 24 inches. It doesn't come with adjustable straps. Depending on the kind of wig I'm making, I might go with a dome cap. But I prefer to use an adjustable wig cap with my frontal wigs. This is not a specific brand. Just type in adjustable wig cap when you're searching for it online. I'm gonna align my frontal on the cap first before doing anything else. And I like to shift it a little bit to the front past the cap, because whenever I wear the cap itself, it pretty much sits about where my hairline is, or even a little bit behind my hairline. Whenever I place the frontal right on the edge of the cap, it kind of slides back when I put it on. Like, it rides back, like it just doesn't want to sit right sometimes. So when I place it a little bit to the front, it's better. I just like it better that way. And then you also want to make sure that the back, like, it's not bumpy anywhere, everything is smooth, like it's not, you know, it's crunching up or riding nowhere, like it's just staying in place. So yeah, then I sew that down. Using four bundles of the deep wave hair from Maven. All details in the info section down below. Whenever I'm making a wig with a closure, I like to measure out some hair wherever the closure is not stitched on, so that whenever like the wind blows or if you try to put it up, things just look better. The cap is covered, the wefts are not showing. So I measure out the hair first. Pretty much showing you this because I also like to do with frontals, but I'm not gonna be doing with mine because it's really not needed. I'm not gonna be putting my wig up. The wind is not gonna be showing that part of the wig because the frontal pretty much covers from ear to ear, so you really are not gonna be seeing anything. But I'm still gonna show you guys just as an option. It's pretty optional. After I finish sewing the hair on the right side up of the cap, I flip it inside out to sew some wefts in it. Pretty much sew it down underneath, not on the band, but on the lace part right close to the band. I'm just showing how it looks once it's flipped up. You don't see the cap, you don't see the weft, you don't see anything, you just see hair. So now I'm just gonna start stitching on the extension. So I start from the back, and I just pretty much stitch back and forth, left to right, right to left, till I make my way up. And yeah, that is it. It's pretty self-explanatory. English is not my first language. So it's pretty much self-explanatory. You sew it back and forth till you wake. What am I saying? I'm so sorry guys, it's been a minute. I made a video even a voiceover, so I'm feeling a little funny right at this point. But yeah, you keep sewing till you get to the top. And that's it. Yeah, just watch the video.
Spend money like say we know they work for ramp. All my only choice, you gotta book it down. Paparazzi flashy, anywhere where we at. Call a monkey, love for more. Only a road. I go fragile, I why. Oh yeah, let's go. Oh yeah, let's go. This fee are today. Tomorrow go better. Penny Shelly, to Mola. I call a war.
And oh, when I was talking about a closure and frontal, some people are really confused by that. A closure is pretty much a smaller version of a frontal. I'm working with a frontal in this video. A frontal goes from ear to ear, it's bigger. it covers more space. And a closure is usually like a 3x4 or 4x5 size, and it pretty much covers like a small area in the front. So yeah, that's what I was talking about, a closure or frontal. A frontal covers the whole front. A closure just closes a small piece in the front. Done. This is about how much hair I had left, so not much. Pretty much used the whole four bundles. Why am I yelling? Stop yelling. Yeah, pretty much used the whole four bundles.
If I dance, she go dance. And if I move, she go move. Baby mama, if I dance.
And then I flipped the wig inside out, cut off the fabric from underneath where the frontal is placed, so that the frontal is visible and, you know, everything. And this is what I was talking about, the hair that I was gonna sew underneath. If I was to sew hair underneath, that's about where I'm gonna sew it on. There are two sizes of elastic bands that I like to use, thinner one for my closure wigs and a thicker one for my frontal wigs. The thicker one just pretty much helps the frontal lay flatter, and the thinner one, it's less visible when you're wearing it with a closure wig. So I'm pretty much measuring out my ear-to-ear measurement, and that's gonna help me determine the length of the elastic band that I'm gonna use. So my ear-to-ear measurement is about 13 inches. Then I take away 7 inches from that, and that's the length of elastic band I'm gonna measure out. I'm gonna sew it to both ends of the frontal, like the very, very edge of the frontal on both sides. That pretty much helps tack down the frontal, like makes it stay flat on your head. But once I'm done with everything, I go ahead and wash the wig and then style it as desired.
You like it to sing your song, so you carry, play the beat, so take it all, take it all, take it all, take it all.
Once everything was dry, the wig was too long for my liking, so I went ahead and started chopping off some bits because I had a different style envisioned in my mind. So I had to start cutting it up, shape it up to make it look like what I wanted to look like. Unfortunately, I had to cut off some. I was kind of sad, but I had to do it. I wasn't really feeling the long look. And then once I was done with that, I went ahead and cut off my lace, which is what I do at the very, very end when I'm sure of everything. Like, I like how everything looks. After that, just placed it on my head. And it's good if you have your hair braided down. Makes everything look a bit flat. I have a kind of like a normal forehead, I would like to think. Some people say like I have a big forehead, but yeah, whatever. So my edges kind of protrude out like on the sides, while, you know, the middle part goes back a little bit. So if I place it to cover everything, I look kind of funny, like the wig kind of comes down too far on my forehead. So I have to kind of place it back to sit on my hairline. Doing that makes a little bit of my edges peep out on the sides, and which is okay. It just kind of makes everything look a bit more natural. Tying the adjustable straps in the back to make things a bit more secure and tighter. And with that, I really don't need anything else to secure it. I can flip it up and down, side to side, whatever. It's not gonna fall off. So yeah, doing some more adjustments right there. And I'm just coming closer to show you guys, you know, the little fuzzy pieces in the front really helps a lot, because you're gonna see a line of demarcation if they're not there with the lace, because of course it's fake, it's not yours, it's not your real scalp. So it's kind of hard to camouflage things, but there are ways to go around it, hence the reason to create the little fuzzy pieces. And I'm just showing you guys my little edges that's showing on the side. It's not really much, but yeah, it's right there. You can kind of just play with the front, place the little fuzzy pieces wherever you want to place it. Yeah, and on the side, sometimes it might flap out, especially when you want to put it up in a high ponytail, it might be flapping up. And I'm going to show you guys a little solution at the end, but if you're going to be wearing it down, it's really not much of a big deal. You can just use the hair to camouflage it and play with it. Since it's a frontal, you can part it anywhere across the front from ear to ear. And because the hair is more of a looser wave, it's not giving me the shape that I want. I'm still not, you know, feeling it fully. So I'm taking a pick comb to pick out the root, to, you know, comb out the root. Not combing out the curls, but, you know, comb out the root, lift it up to give it more volume, to for it to flare out. I want it to flare out a bit. I don't want it to just sit flat on my head. I want the hair in the front to be a bit more tamed, so I'm using this got to be glued hair gel. Disclaimer, this is not a glue. No glue. We're not using glue. This is not a glue. It's just a hair gel. It's just a very strong hair gel. Water makes it come off just like that. Like, you don't need anything else. Just put water on it and you lift it up. That's it. I got hip to this gel. You know, I was searching online how to make your lace frontal or lace wig stay down without glue, and some people were using this. So I was like, yo, I'm gonna try it out. This can have the potential to make your edges look white, like leave a white residue. So whenever you're using it, you wanna use some water on your hair first. You need very tiny, not too much, because if you use too much, you're gonna be looking like a big ball of white clouds, like on your head. Like, you don't want that. And this is what it's gonna look like if you don't put enough water. Like, it's just gonna look like you have white stuff in your head. So you can place it underneath the frontal, let it get a little tacky, then you place the lace down wherever it's lifting up. Or you can just place it on your little fuzzy hairs and it kind of sips through the lace and tacks down onto your head. So either way you do it, it works. Let it dry. You kind of have yourself a little baby hair there. And if you don't want the baby hair look, just use some water to position the hair wherever you want it. Let it dry and the hair is gonna stay how you want it. Yeah, that's the final look. Hopefully you guys found this video helpful. I'm gonna leave some helpful links in the info section down below. Previous videos you can refer to in terms of customizing a frontal, bleaching knots, making wigs, all that good stuff. Information on the hair is gonna be in the info section down below. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll talk to you all later.